Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. My name is David, this is David K Reacts, and here I ramble with articulation, I hope, about the audio and visual of a variety of videos, mostly musical. And today I'm going to be checking out Voctiv, a group that we've had a few times on the channel, and specifically their video of Goodnight My Someone from Meredith Wilson's The Music Man. This is a musical I adore. I heard it when I was younger. Probably around, I would guess, 12. And a couple of things struck me straight away. One, 76 trombones was an absolutely phenomenal piece of music. Two, Marion the Librarian was an even better piece of music for me. And three, of course, and I can't remember what it's called now, naturally, but the Barbershop Quartet. I've always loved barbershop music. And so the fact that there was a Barbershop Quartet in a musical was so far up my street, I pretty much lived there. That's going to annoy the living daylights out of me until I remember what it's called. And so I am going to have a look. Goodnight, ladies. There we go. Which, of course, mixes with Pick a Little, Talk a Little. If you don't know this musical, it is absolutely adorable. It tells the story of Harold Hill, who is a musical instrument seller and charlatan, who comes to town and purports to be able to sell all the instruments to create a marching band. And that he'll, you know, all this sort of thing. But he's completely kind of making up his ability to teach a band how to play, and he ends up getting stuck doing so. And everybody's sort of on the verge of finding him out, and he always manages to squeak by. And in the process, he falls in love with Marion, who is the town librarian. And he ends up making good, and it's beautiful. It's a lovely show. It has some fantastic music in it, some really, really marvelous pieces of music, and this is one of them. Goodnight My Someone is a gorgeous song, and it's sung twice in the show. The first time around, Marion is teaching piano to a young girl called Amaryllis, who says, "Who do I say goodnight to if I don't have a sweetheart to say goodnight to?" And Marion says, "Well, you say goodnight to my someone, whoever that may be," and sings the song in full, accompanied at the beginning by Amaryllis, which is quite cute. And then later it's reprised, and she actually sings it with Harold Hill. He's outside singing 76 trombones. She's inside singing Goodnight My Someone, and they end up switching. He takes over this melody. She takes over 76 trombones. It's a lovely moment. It's very, very sweet. And that sense that they're both singing each other's songs, but don't realize that the other one is right there. And, you know, if they just turned around and looked through the window, they would know the other one was there. It's very adorable. And it's such a fantastic piece of music. The show won the Oscar for Best New Musical. If I recall correctly, it beat out West Side Story, which tells you a lot about how highly it was thought of. This is at the Tonys, incidentally. Which tells you how highly it was thought of at the time. Both of the major Broadway revivals were also nominated for Best Revival of a Musical. It's very well thought of. And, you know, if I started singing 76 trombones lead the grand parade, you probably know that tune. Here's the secret. This is the same tune. Goodnight, My Someone, it's not quite the same, it's not 100% the same, but Goodnight, My Someone is based around the tune of 76 trombones, or vice versa. I don't know which one was written first, but they are... Goodnight, My Someone, 76 trombones lead... They're the same thing, just with different embellishments and different focuses and obviously a slightly different feel. 76 trombones is a very martial, marching band 4/4 piece, where Goodnight My Someone is in a much slower, more languid 3/4 waltz tempo. But, you know, they work together beautifully, and that's why they reprise so beautifully together as well, because not only do they go well and, you know, if the singers are good, they blend beautifully, but they are, you know, it's more or less the same song being reprised together. Anyway, with all of that said, I'm really excited to see what Voctiv does with this. It's such a gorgeous piece of music, and I loved what they did with the trolley song, and I'm really excited to see what they do with this. They're, you know, I know they have their Christmas canon and all that sort of thing that is so fantastic, but they seem to have a solid musical theatre canon behind them as well. Oh, and the Disney canon, of course. But they do have some lovely musical theatre in there as well, and yeah, I'm excited to see what happens here. So without any further delay, I shall say welcome back to my channel. Welcome if this is your first time here. If it is, I'm going to watch this video straight through. I'm going to comment and emote over the top of it. And then I will go back to the beginning and watch again. And that time I will pause, I will interrupt, and I'll offer what commentary and analysis I feel I can based on what I've seen and heard, and what the foreknowledge, rather, of having seen it once before. Please do like the video, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, and select how often you'd like to be notified, and if you'd care to support the channel, you can do so with a one-off donation at buymeacoffee.com/DavidKReacts, with an ongoing donation of $2 Canadian at patreon.com/DavidKReacts, where you can also gain access to my Discord, or you can buy a super thanks here on YouTube, and I will get back to you very quickly if you do so. All of those lovely, no pressure to do so. And that's that. So this is going to be Voctive performing Meredith Wilson's Good Night, My Someone. The same arpeggiated intro from the score. I love that. Oh, gorgeous. Oh, that entry. Ooh. Oh, that chord is stunning. Oh, I love that gap. That's lovely. That's a really nice choice. Oh, that sequence. Oh, that's really nice. The switch. And then all together. Oh. Ooh. Oh, that's nice. Oh, this is just beautiful. Yes, Kate. Oh. Oh. Oh, yes. Oh, the purity. Oh, wow. That is so good. I mean, in some ways, that's kind of what I expected, in the sense that I know how amazingly good Voctive are. They made some really interesting choices, though, that I did not see coming. This is the title track to an album, I see. I love that. Also, what a beautiful piece of artwork. So simple for an album entitled Good Night, My Someone. The moon as the O is perfect. That's lovely. And I love that the V is hidden behind the clouds. That is the kind of simple detail that, for me, elevates a piece of artwork. It would be so easy with the rest of the words being in front of the clouds that are very obviously behind them. They could have just had the whole thing up front, but the fact that they've layered it into the image by hiding the V, and you can even, I think, there's just a touch right here I don't know how well that shows up on the reduced screen here, or here rather, but there's just a touch, I think, of the V peeking through the clouds. That is so well done. Very beautifully crafted image. The attention to detail like that really makes something. I mean, you see what I mean, right? It's a beautiful piece of music, but they harmonized that to perfection. And of course, Kate, the perfect choice for this song. The purity in her voice is exactly what I think it's such a perfect fit for Marion, who, you know, she is the foil to Harold Hill, right? He's our protagonist, but he's not a particularly good guy at the beginning. His arc is to change and become a better man. And Marion is sort of the fulcrum around which that happens. She's not necessarily always the cause of it, although definitely at some points. But she has to be the purity that counteracts his sort of manipulation. And Kate's voice is perfect for that. That was good. And some of the entries, the chords, the way that they judged the length of certain notes. Let's go again. I need to listen to that again because this is beautiful. Simplicity. I just talked about simplicity. I love, first of all, that even on the white screen at the beginning, you can see the shadow. There's just enough there that we can see, and I say shadow, it's like a light shadow, but you can see there is somebody on the screen, and the gradual fade in, you know, the handheld camera, it's just a nice touch. But on the doo-doo, the name of the group and the title come up. It's so simple, but it's so effective. And I like the fact they divided it into two. Gives you time to read it, and you know, you get the name before you get the title. That's great. But timing it with the music, of course they do that, but it's exactly what it should be. And this is such a beautiful intro, and I said it's authentic to the show. So this is the full version of the song, obviously not the reprise. There's no 76 trombones in there. But at the full version of the song, the accompaniment is started by Amaryllis playing the piano. And she plays this on the piano. And at the very end, she goes... And instead of going up with her right hand, this is in the movie at any rate, swings her left hand over for up at the top. And it's just really cute. The way they've chosen to do this with just this very simple unison representation of that exact same figure is so good. It would have been so easy to slide into harmony here or to start out with chords or something like that, but they stuck to what was actually written in the original score, and that, in my opinion, was a great choice. Really great choice. Okay, once again. Also, one other nice thing about that little intro is they've timed. You get the do do do, and whoever's singing, say, the second note, it's do do. Excuse me, frog in my throat. And they've timed the cutoff there, so all three notes come off at once and then restart, which is more or less how you would play it if you were playing this on the piano. You might hold on do 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 do, and then change the pedal for do do do. However, it worked, but. They're mimicking a piano a little bit. Not too much, but a little bit. And it's just enough that it fits really, really well.
Good night, my someone. Good night, my love. Sleep tight, my someone.
Oh, and that intro. I love that we get the full first two lines of the song. With Kate, of course, singing beautifully. She comes in, the tone as she enters is just stunning, but we get two lines of the song with exactly the same accompaniment. Exactly what we've just heard. And then, and only then, do you get the dum-dum-dum, and the men come in lower and fill out that richness. But it starts it out, it makes the point that this is a solo female song with a degree of innocence to it. It's very, very light. And then we add in that richness. Good night, my someone. Good night, my love. In comes that warmth to support that statement just there. This is very lullaby-esque, but it could just as equally be a love song, as it kind of is when the reprise comes around. And they've captured that mixed tone with this so very well. Just want to hear Kate come in again.
Good night, my someone. Good night, my love.
I also love the amount of vibrato that she's putting in here. It's very, it's slight. We know she can have a bigger one, this is very slight. She's keeping it quite clean and then just letting it in at the end. Then a couple of notes, it's there a bit more. She's balancing it really, really nicely to keep the clean tone of the sound at this point. Really nice choice. And such a lovely choice to have them come in on the do 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 do. So they're coming in level with the female part of the chorus that's been singing already. And so they just join in, you know, equal in sound, just lower. And then everybody changes onto the lyric. And that's a really nice decision because it kind of gives it a swell instead of coming in too strongly. Beautiful choice. And it's a nice choice there to our star, as she goes up to the star. No, not happening today. Our star. As she goes up there, they push with her and then fall back. And we go back to the vocalization instead of the lyrics again. They pull back slightly in volume. They've kind of buoyed her up and then pull back. And it's a lovely character moment that she kind of goes up there with this swell and then is just left to sail. That's really, really nice. Oh, also, there's a beautiful note.
Someone sleep ties my love.
Love. That's such an interesting note in there. It's the way that it's just standing out very slightly. It's the subdominant of our tonic key, so the fourth, but it's the seventh of the chord they're actually singing at that point. Love, love, love. No, I beg your pardon. I'm telling a complete lie. I misheard that. It is the second. So it is it's the fifth of that chord.
One, sleep ties, my love.
There's our tonic of that chord, and it's the da, and it's the la da, and you get that lovely. But that da, it's there, but it doesn't stand out quite as much. Which is a really interesting decision to me. We hear that note push through very slightly. It gives a slight sense of we're going to resolve, but the resolution is not as clear. It falls back again slightly, which is really nice because the chorus kind of leaves on a little bit of a lingering note and then pulls away while Kate sails on. Really, really nice.
Is my love our star?
Oh, that chord is so rich. Da, da. There's that minor sixth. Dum, 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 da. We've gone down there. But the notes that are coming over the top of it.
It's bright as life.
Ah, there it is again. That second just coming through. The way they're using that note. And that's interesting because da, 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 da. That's a tritone. That is the furthest apart you could possibly be between two octaves. You have that and that. Na, da, da. That's the exact center of the octave, which is a really, really rich sound when it is paired the way that it is here. It can feel really open. It can feel haunting or creepy, but it can also feel rich when you support it with the appropriate notes to form it into like a dominant seventh chord or something like that, which is what they're doing here. They're filling it out with notes and making this rich sound. But the fact that that second is coming through again, just that little bit more, it's such an interesting choice. And this time, comes through a little bit more. Even as they're moving around, we get that upward resolution that I was expecting the first time to come through a little bit more. Really good work. I love how long she holds that for. That clean note that just goes into the vibrato towards the end. Perfectly, perfectly sort of realized in the way that she's chosen to sing it. I love they hold that on. There's so much in this. She's singing, like her, the chorus is not the quietest I've heard them in a balance. This is what I think is so impressive about Voctiv's mixing and arrangement. There's a big sound there, and yet, obviously she's high, which helps, but Kate is still so clear of them in the mix. Even though there's quite a presence there of this rich harmony, it never overpowers Kate. And it's beautiful. It's such a great balance that has been struck. One other thing I really like was their timing of good for the final good night there. They sing do 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 good night. They just stick to that rhythm, whereas she has that slight hold on the good night and comes in a little bit later. That little bit of the slight hold that she has before she comes in on that is really, really nice, because it kind of gives a little bit more of a bounce up to the night, but it's also draws the ear, and you hear the good night even against the chorus in a way that you might not if it was all in perfect lockstep. Also, their use of lyrics and different vocalizations. They before this line, they were back out into the open ah, and then they pull back into the ooh again, and here again, good night, ooh. Good night, ooh. I don't know what the notes are, but they have that, the bar of the open ah sound of night, and then pull back to the ooh for the last two chord shifts, and then stay on it for this lovely held note. Their choice of vocalization is superb, and it allows a little bit of crescendo and decrescendo within the group, even without changing their volume much, because they're changing their resonance center. They're making the mouth do more resonance. They're using a wider mouth shape for night or ah, as they are for ooh. Changes everything about how the voice is perceived, and they're using that to such great effect. This is so lovely. Then we go into the chorus singing, and Kate just, I don't know if she's blending into the chorus at this point. I feel like she's just not singing here and just letting the chorus do their thing. This is just gorgeous. And we have this lovely climbing bass line that's supporting them as they're singing. It kind of gives it this lovely forward motion. This is beautiful. Sweet dreams, be yours, dear, if dreams there be. Sorry, it's the tenor line that's climbing. I was misremembering that, but do do do, and then you get that lovely do, from the basses coming into that. But that this grand kind of sound that keeps forming and falling away and forming and falling away. It's the swells in this are just extraordinary. Great job with the arrangement here, Jamie. And as always, the way Voctiv holds this together is just fantastic. I love that we get these moments in this, and it's such a cute touch that we see moments of them not recording. Like, it would be very easy to make this just them performing the whole way through, and it would be great. But the fact that we get these little cheeky, but I love that just peek through the curtains and like little moments where they're just being themselves and clearly having a good time in the studio. It's a really, really nice touch. I love that choice there to have close off to me, giving us that little bit of a gap there. It's just, it's serves so many purposes. It gives us a little bit of an aural break, which then means that you refocus on to me because something different has happened. It catches the ear. But there's also that sense of close to me and that memory of being close for a split second. Like, it just gives us a little bit of an emotional punch as well, and I love that. It's a really nice choice. And then you get that lovely to me and these beautiful harmonies, these chromatics that creep in here and there. This arrangement is wonderful. Oh, that is outstanding, that chord sequence. I'm going to increase the volume in my headphones for a second, just because I can hear the furnace very slightly in the background. I just want to listen to that again. I wish they may, and I wish they might. Oh, that is, it's so rich. That wish they may, and I wish. And then on that wish... the second wish, they take off and they have a downward moving part for a second that goes places you don't expect, and then they hit that chord, or that note rather, at the bottom, and the rest of the chorus resolves into them. That is beautiful. And again, lovely example of the basses catching your ear, providing you with interest because they're doing something different, and then allowing the piece to resolve into this gorgeous harmony. And then they slide down to the bottom there and just kind of round out that sound. That sequence is stunning. I wish they may, and I wish... May. We've heard that. That was the one I was talking about just before, and they then went down to that really rich minor sixth. But this time they go even further with creating cool harmony. You hear that might from everybody else, and it's a little clashy on the might, and then we resolve up into a fuller chord that, as I say, the basses fill out when they drop down at the end. That is perfection. Now good night, my someone, good night. And there, that is so good, because we then have good night, my someone, good night. Perfectly standard chords. We just kind of have that natural finish into our tonic, but then the tenors hold on the night, and that minor seventh creeps in as we then move into the subdominant. Beautiful motion, but I love the way that they do this change. Everybody else fades away. That at the end of night, there are points here where they're a little bit more specific with pronouncing consonants, and there it doesn't happen. Good night, and they just fade away, and the tenors night, and they don't. There's probably a in there a little bit, like that sort of tongue tongue to the top of the mouth T that isn't a T. It doesn't have the plosive expulsion of air. It's just a T. It's the tongue making sound more than anything. That's probably in there a little bit. I might not be hearing it right now with the... As I've said before, these headphones give me beautiful quality of sound, but sometimes there are very slight subtleties that I will miss. I've noticed that when I then switch to AirPods, I hear slightly different things, but this is the better quality of sound overall. But just that choice to have that kind of hanging and then just that transition note carrying through to the new chord. Beautiful. And then we lose the guys again. We just have the female voices, especially coming out of having those tenors held on. And it's nice because we get two things. One, we go from having the that suspension into the new chord being sung by male voices that then get kind of dropped as we move to the female section and go higher up the register. But also we've had that transition. We've had all the voices, the bass section has dropped away, other voices have too, but the bass section drops and then we transition through the tenors up and go into the female voice. So there's a lovely kind of sweep up that happens there as well. Really beautiful chords here too. That heart. There's a little change there, and you get it. I think there's a second in there somewhere, two notes a tone apart from each other that resolves very quickly, but it just gives you a little bit of a crunch that they slide away from very quickly. But there's all these passing notes where it's like, I'm going from this chord, but I'm going to hit this note on the way, that are just stunning, and they add so much richness and texture to what we're hearing. Oh, and that final chord, heart. I don't even know what, I can't even quite figure out what note they're hitting at that final chord. But again, just that little bit of dissonance that's in there. It's perfectly in place. It doesn't sound wrong, but my goodness, it adds so much to what we're hearing. From heart to heart. Our lovers are parted, they say. Ooh! Ooh, nice low note down there, thank you basses. But I love that we again get this very simple re-entry with the men. Now we've switched, we get that change back down again, but this is more of a drop really. There isn't a passing tenor line or low alto line that feeds us from A to B. We just drop down to the men and they come in, and then we get this very traditional bass line. There doesn't sound like there's any, or not like men's chorus line. But then you get a couple of unusual notes as they start moving on say at the end there. Hey, say. It's not quite that, is it? Say. But that on that final change, the A with the men down on the bottom there. It's just a little tiny instance of another, I think it's a second again. Say. Right, because the lower the basses hit the boom, the duh, and then you get the ba-dum on the same thing. So it's that sixth to the fifth change there that just gives you a little bit of something a little crunchier that then goes away again when they transition down. It's beautiful. But I must depend on a wish and a star. Lovely choice there to focus on the consonant. Emotion in singing comes from vowels. Understanding in singing comes from consonants. That's how kind of how you usually break it up. But depend at that moment. Right there. But I must depend on a wish and a star. It just gives us a little bit more of that, the swelling thing. I must depend on a wish. It's almost like we've gone da 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 da. There's just a momentary dip, and it allows again, it's this kind of slight volume change as they pull back, and I don't think they're singing much quieter, but they're singing a much quieter sound, and so the translation is that you get this little dip for a second in the volume, and again this swell, this the way that they're playing with these sounds is just marvelous. And And there it sounds like it's going to be so straight, and we key change out of nowhere. I love that. That note there is like, where did that come from? Beautiful stuff. And it's just, it's such an easily managed change, and it's such a surprise. It's, oh, that's wonderful. And just to come back in at that point with Kate solo in the new key, taking off once again. Lovely. And what an interesting chord there. So going up to the subdominant in the bass is there, such an unusual move. And we have this beautiful flowing, these flowing R's over the top of it. It's like water flowing over a riverbed. It's just extraordinary. And then Kate, just angelic up at the top there. Oh, that's so gorgeous. And again, you get that close, just cuts off not quite as quickly from Kate, and yet the chorus carries it on. This time there's more richness to that imagination. And I love that we have Tiffany climbing there behind Kate, and then she just comes back down again as Kate jumps up once again to that that third. This is stunning. Oh, and Dreams on its own. Sweet dreams are having that one note. That one beat where she sings Dreams by herself, again, propels us up to join her, and then everybody else comes in behind. Another example of holding it on so perfectly. The length of that is gorgeous, and I love that motion there on Might. Sorry, on Wish. And then on Might, the Wish. Wish they might, whatever the notes are. And I love that we go, wish them the change there. Then we're on the same note. And at the same time underneath them. And I wish they wish they might. So you get wish they might. The changes are happening at different places. And what that means is because we staggered when there are note changes, it sounds like we have so many more. Well, we do have more chord changes than we could do based on how much is happening, because the movements are happening each beat, but they're not happening each beat with everybody. And so we're creating these small changes that are nonetheless changing the sound as we go, but it's not the whole chorus all the time, which also works perfectly well. I just love they've chosen to go this route at this point, and we gradually form this rich chord on Might that we're going to land on, and indeed the one it resolves into. But we've done that piecemeal with everybody changing and falling into place at different times. Lovely stuff. I love this. That is wonderful. I like, first of all, just her. Again, that lovely use of just having a beat. Oh, good night. A single beat of her on her own just to bring us back into it, and then everybody swells in beneath. And then this lovely change, these moving, walking chords down here. and they're somewhere in there. There's a shift in there. Where is it? I think it is. -6, -6, -5, -6. I think is the change that's happening there. Might be two different parts shifting. I'm not 100% sure. But that shift in the middle of that takes that beautiful chord already and makes it so much crunchier as we have that shift between the descending minor, which is both resolving but also has a sadness to it, as she goes up to the good night. And then it shifts up and there's a hopefulness to the rise back up to the sixth rather than the minor sixth. And then that gorgeous resolution down. That phrase is, like, I've got goosebumps now. That is magnificent. And again, this the minor sixth down to the fifth once more. I love how we keep hearing these same changes featured very slightly in the mix, but each time they sound different. This time there is nothing sad about that minor sixth. It's just a clear indication that we're going into a cadence. It's gorgeous. And how does a person sound so purely angelic and look like they're putting no effort into it at all? She makes it look so easy. And I know that is the result of a huge amount of work, and I'm not in any way saying she's not working hard. But she makes it look like anybody in the world could just open their mouth and this sound would come out. And of course, that's not true at all. It's stunning. It is stunning. And I love, again, we don't get the t on there. Good night. It just resolves down and gives us this beautiful harmonic finish. And they leave the T, the hard T that could have been there. It's just not there. And there it is from her. Spectacular choice. Also interesting is they actually sing the whole diphthong. No, it's very quick. You hear the I don't think the T is there that time though. When I was talking about the T earlier, I did hear just a fraction of it as I played it that final time and moved on. I don't think it's there that time. I think they just leave the consonant. They finish the diphthong, which is a really interesting choice. And it gives us this slight change of quality in the background as she sails on up tonight. And then they just settle down onto this beautiful ooh. And I like the fact it's, an interesting decision to end with two different vowel sounds. We have night up top from Kate and ooh from everybody else, which are two contrasting sounds. But because she's singing the brighter sound, again, she's very high, of course, that draws the ear. But she's also singing the wider, more resonant sound. And so we're going to hear her better because of that as well. It's a really, really nice decision just to pull the chorus back one final time at the very, very end of the song. This is amazing! This is truly amazing. Jamie, applause as always. Your arranging is superlative. But the performances in this as well. Kate, my goodness, just wonderful as always. But everybody in this, I didn't count how many we had this time, probably the 11 again, I would guess. Just so beautiful, pitch perfect for the tone of this song, I think. Really, really well done. I'm so glad I chose to look at this. This is... I could feel myself, like, if I let myself, I would probably cry a little with this, but also there's something about it that is so hopeful and so positive that it also buoys me up a little, too. It's magnificent. Bravo. Bravo. Love it. Thank you very, very much for being with me if you're still here watching this. I hope that you enjoyed that and that I was able to bring something to you, be it a facet of the song you hadn't noticed, the song itself, the Music Man. Hey, go check out the musical, the 19 whatever it was movie. When did it come out? I don't remember when the movie came out. The musical was the late 50s. But the movie with Shirley Jones and Robert Preston as Marion and Harold Hill is superb. Go check that out. Or Voctiv. If you haven't heard Voctiv before, go listen to Voctiv. They're stunning. But yeah, I hope you managed to enjoy this. And thank you for spending your time with me. I appreciate it. Please like the video if you did enjoy. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, as I was saying earlier. And if you'd like to support me, once again, you can do so at buymeacoffee.com/DavidKReacts, at patreon.com/DavidKReacts, or at here on YouTube with a super thanks. And any of those, gratefully appreciated if you would care to do so. I think that's everything for now. So again, thank you for joining me for this video, and I will be back next week with more. I've already recorded next week's video, actually, and it's something a little different for me, but with a group that I'm very familiar with, so I hope you will enjoy that. Have an absolutely wonderful rest of your day, morning, evening, afternoon, whatever time it happens to be. 5:30 a.m. Not going to get anyone at 5:30 a.m., am I? But take care of yourselves, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.